to go, is that alright?
Yeah.
So, because this is sort of the rise of Morgan Whisker, sort of, I want to know sort of where it all started with you. Like, when was it you actually got into the Derby Academy?
I'd say it was about when I was seven, I think, because I think it was my seventh or eighth birthday, I was mascot against Man United. And I think if you say that's what sort of got me to sign. It was quite funny because Rooney was obviously playing at that time, so I just think I was a mascot at that young age against him and now training with him every day. So a bit surreal to think and crazy to think, but yeah, that's probably where it all started.
And so were you playing in like a local team before that, or was it literally as soon as you started playing football you were in the Derby County Academy?
Yeah, local team, Swindon Dynamos. Just playing there, weekends, and then just sort of got picked up by Derby.
What is it like? Because obviously you said seven, that's such an early age. So all you've probably known is growing up in an academy, growing life in football. What is it like to grow up in an academy?
I think it's good, because obviously you get to play football every day, play against Premier League teams, just get better as a player, and I think it's good.
And obviously this has been your home for quite some time then, Moore Farm, and the facilities here are great. Just how much has this place helped you as a player?
Yeah, it's really helped. You see over the years it's gone from where category was to category one now, and I think it's obviously best for the players because of the facilities, and even just being able to go, you use the gym, use the sports hall, use them facilities in your own time, that's what helps just a little bit.
And of course it's not just like Derby you've been playing for, like you've been in and out of the like sort of England setup and stuff.
Yeah.
So what's that been like?
Yeah, it's great because you can't complain when you're representing your country, but I think again it's just only the start, it's a building block to be able to play for the seniors. So
it's all working towards that,
yeah,
that final ultimate aim. And I remember I started reporting on Derby last year, and that's when you sort of had quite a good season, it's fair to say, 40 goal contributions or something ridiculous like that. So that's sort of what started it off for you.
Yeah, really. But I think, again, it was just the aim to be in the first team every week, even starting every week. So I'm still making my way up there. It's just a start and it's a good start. All I can do is keep going each day.
And you talk about, because you've been in the first team this season, you've been in the academy, that's sort of the life of an academy footballer, sort of on the fringes. That's not something you mind though, is it? As long as you're playing football, you can be in either team, whether it's the under 23s or the first team.
Yeah, I think that's a good thing. As long as I'm playing football, I'm happy. But again, if I'm playing for the 23s, I want to make a good performance, so I'm considered for the first team. I think it's all about the first team, but if I'm playing Champions League 19s or 23s, it's all built into the first team really, but it's football, so I can't complain.
And it started at Scunthorpe. You came on as a substitute against Scunthorpe. Lovely Scunthorpe. How was that for you?
Yeah, it's great because obviously making my first team debut at team I've been at since I was like 7, 8. So that's all the years in the academy have built up to that moment. And obviously, hopefully it's going to carry on. I find it's great to say, but I find it more nervous if I was playing 23s or 19s than first team. Don't know why, but I prefer it first team.
Okay. Then you made your first championship start under Koku. How did that come about? Is it something that Koku came to you and told you you're going to be starting at Pride Park? And then what was your reaction to that?
It's not so much that. It's like we'll do training drills and you'll set one team up and that'll be the starting team. So the day before you sort of get a taster and then the team will come up on the day.
And like I say, it was Koku who's given you these opportunities. He's given the likes of like Louis Sibley, Jason Knight, like all these youth players. There must be like a buzz around the youth academies because you know that you've got a manager who's willing to put faith in the young players.
Yeah, it's definitely nice to have a manager like that because previously it's not been like that. But I think Koku is probably the best manager for that, and we can't complain as young lads because obviously giving us opportunities and a chance to play for the first team.
What's the ultimate aim for you? Is it just to get a regular spot in that first team?
Yeah, I think starting most weeks. Yeah, I suppose starting every week in my opinion, but just got to keep taking it day to day. I can't look and say I should be starting each day. When playing 23, it's just another opportunity to show why I should be starting.
Just keep going and going?
Yeah.
Sounds perfect. Thank you, mate. Good luck with that.
Thank you.